Hello everybody, welcome back to the kitchen. It has been quite some time since my last cooking video and it's definitely time for another one. It is Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas to everybody out there, even though this video is probably going to come out after the holidays. But anyway, this is one of the things I'm making for our Christmas dinner. This is a butternut squash apple soup. Really great appetizer to serve before the main course of turkey or ham or whatever you're having. What I have here is a butternut squash, one of the squash that I grew in my garden this year. I'm starting with one. I'll probably cut up a second one, maybe a smaller one. Some apples. I guess you could use whatever apple you have around, but I like Granny Smith. I'm also going to use some of these to make an apple pie later. But I like them because they have a real strong apple flavor. They're nice and tart. You know, sweet apples are just sweet, but a tart apple, like a Granny Smith, has a lot of good apple flavor. And we're also going to be using some apple cider as well. And on the stove, starting to heat up, is just some vegetable stock. You could also use chicken stock or whatever else you want. You could use water. You could use extra apple cider. There was one year I used only apple cider for the liquid part of the soup. And it was good. It was a little bit too strong on the apple. But anyway, I skinned the squash. I cut off the top of it, which doesn't have any seeds in it. And then of course you'll have to cut this in half and gut the seeds out later for the bottom half. And just slice it up and dice it up. The smaller the pieces that you make, the quicker everything will cook and soften. Slice those up and we're just going to throw these into the stock. So we got our butternut squash in there. We've got two Granny Smith apples I peeled and cored and chopped up. Slide those in there. And this is a good time to add some herbs and spices. I have rosemary. And if you've watched my videos, you know me. I don't really have measurements for spices. I just kind of put them until they seem good. But that was maybe a teaspoon of rosemary, a little bit of celery seed, maybe a half a teaspoon of that, ground sage, half teaspoon maybe, thyme, I guess about the same amount, and Italian seasoning, I guess once again the same amount, a little bit of black pepper. Some salt. Now I'll pour in some apple cider. That was, I don't know, maybe a half cup or so. As this boils, of course, some of it's going to steam off and you're going to lose some liquid. Just looking in here, it seems like there's plenty of liquid. So when I blend all this together, it'll be a good consistency. But you can play with it, of course. But I think about a half cup or so was good for now. We can always adjust it later. Now all you gotta do, let's see, I'm gonna turn this down to like a low, medium, low, just like a simmer. Cover it up and let it go for a while. Maybe, I don't know, half hour, hour, just, it doesn't really matter too much. Just keep poking everything with a fork or something and see how soft or hard it is. If it's still hard, keep going. And if it's nice and soft, we're ready for the next step. Alright, it's probably been, I don't know, an hour at least. And it has definitely done cooking. As you can see, everything is nice and mushy. So, we're ready to blend this up. So the best tool for that is one of these submersible, blenders. And you just want to watch out, once this starts becoming more of a pureed mixture with it on the stove, it'll kind of turn into a soupy volcano of really hot soup. So make sure you don't burn yourself. And there you have it, everybody. Just as simple as that. We're done. I just gave it a quick taste test, and the spices and everything I put in were just right. I don't think it really needs anything else. The flavor of the butternut squash is there, but it's just kind of added on to with the rosemary and thyme and everything. The consistency I think is perfect. It's a little bit thin, a little bit thick. I think it's just right. You can of course adjust it as you want. If you want this thicker, just put another butternut squash in there, a little less broth, or just let it boil off. You know, take the lid, keep the lid off and let it simmer for a while to thicken. But I think this is just right. And serving suggestion, when you put it into a bowl, put a little dollop of whipped cream on it, and it'll be perfect. It'll be a great appetizer for your Christmas or Thanksgiving or New Year's dinner. So that's it, everybody. Thanks for watching. Hope you make this. Hope you enjoy it. Leave a comment down below if you feel so inclined, if you have any ideas or comments or anything like that. That's it, everybody. Thanks for watching, and Merry Christmas.